In this video, we'll be talking about the TPA component editing add-in. In this particular model, you can see that I have a very large path, body1z, that contributes a lot to the overall, in both the calculated total from the model and the measured total. To see how body1z breaks, I can click on the path-specific display, and in the path-specific display, I can pick my target, microphone, third order, and I can look at different pads. I'm going to look at body1z, and we can see that, body1z is pretty big. If I compare it to body1y, that's a lot smaller. And if I look at the breakdown of body1z in terms of FRF and force, I can see that there's FRF has a peak here. The force also has a peak. And I can see the mount stiffness and the accelerations on both sides of the mount. When I want to edit this model and change some of the dynamic properties, I can go to Tools Add-ins and I can add in the TPA component editing add-in, 45 tokens. I can say open edit here and I get some cursors and I can position this cursor, for example, on this FRF peak. If I pick edit, in the resulting menu, I can select remove peak. I could say 90% reduction in that peak. I press OK, and instantly I can see the modified FRF and the modified totals. So I can see that I'm getting a pretty big reduction here from the original levels to the new levels, several dB. I can do multiple modifications. For example, maybe I want to adjust the mount rate. So I could come in here, adjust the cursors, pick edit, and this time I'll pick add offset, 6 dB offset on the mount, hit OK, and I got even lower levels. When I'm ready, I can say, let's save this model, and I can call it mount and FRF, for example, hit save here, and then if I pick close edit, I can easily switch between my original model and my modified model. When using the TPA software, it's convenient to switch between these model editions and several of the other modules. Thank you, and I hope that helped explain TPA component editing add-in.